up on DIG. Pack your bags as Ty Loomis and Hans Stolfus present a video diary of their recent trip to Serbia, a place where the fellas, along with Angie Akers and Jenn Snyder, provided a little R&R to the good men and women serving overseas. We'll also take you out to Reno, Nevada for the Volleyball Festival, a place where over 700 club volleyball teams converged on the biggest little city in the world for the largest annual sporting event on Earth. Plus, Phil Dahlhauser and Todd Rogers run through Seaside Heights Open, all-access style.
What's up? I'm Geeter, and welcome to the DIG Show, brought to you by our good friends at Crocs. With Long Beach and Chicago right around the corner and the midway point of the season just passed, I hear things, rumblings, shakeups, and breakups. And it all starts with Casey Jennings and Matt Furbringer, reunited because it feels so good. It's official. Matty's on his way back from Berlin, and he sent the text message. They are back together. So what does that do with Mark Williams? I heard he already called Nick Lucena, and that's official. They're together. Big question mark. What about Sean Scott? The guy's one of the best blockers, one of the best players in the world. Who's he going to play with? Dax Holdren and Jeff Nygaard? I heard they split. Dax is going to play with Kevin Wong for the next 2 weeks, Long Beach and Chicago, because Karchi's taken off. Where does that leave Nygaard? The guy's a two-time NCAA Player of the Year or former MVP. I don't know. Aaron Wachvogel, great defender. What are you going to do, kid? And the women, Logan Tom and Holly McPeak, they've had four top five finishes. They've been in a final. They are officially split. Logan Tom's going to play with Diane Dinekashe. That leaves Holly and Barb Fontana, two of the greatest players of all time. They have no partner. I heard they're lining up down the beach at tryouts. All right, enough of me. Let's get on with the show. Here's an all-access pass with the number one team, Phil and Todd.
The best team in the world.
It was really hard to beat.
That's a big ball guy. That's a real good partner.
In 2005, I was playing with Sean Scott. I've been playing with him for 4 years. But I just saw so much potential in Phil. I just felt like a guy like that was the future of the sport.
Blocking you, I think.
No, I got one.
Oh, that's right, you didn't cover it, huh? Using knuckle pokey, you think?
They don't make mistakes, you know. Any mistake you make, they're gonna take advantage of.
I think we're on a 5-week drought. And after winning 5 of the first 6, you get used to winning. So it would be nice to win this and be back in the W column. There you go.
That's a little workout for you too, huh? Little morning wake-up call.
Thanks.
All right, we'll see you guys. Good luck.
Scouting report, don't serve him.
Yes!
I'll take that.
You know, he's rarely ever a goofball. He's a quiet guy. He doesn't really say much. I mean, I'm a pretty quiet guy usually as well. When he's talking to his girlfriend, I make trouble for him in the background. I just sit there and say, oh, yeah, how was that party last night, Phil? Or talking a girl's voice or whatever. And sometimes it gets on her nerves, and I just crack up. He's like, shut up.
Come on, Phil.
Yeah,
that's
it.
Hey! The bad sets, they stay up.
Basically, it's out.
It's almost every time.
All right.
I'm just worried about the kid. That way the kid's probably 3-1.
Let's squeeze it through.
You know, my goal is to make Phil the best player he can be as a coach.
Don't go extreme to the angle.
No, because otherwise just kind of
wait.
Yeah,
exactly. No, just what I do is the ball and let me do the baiting.
He's a cerebral guy and understands the game.
What I do is I just kind of line up on the angle side of the ball and then take a step into the line.
Dahlhauser Rogers advancing to the finals.
I was thinking about going in the water, but I keep being told it's like 55 degrees, which is freezing cold. Maybe if I can find a wetsuit, I'll grab a board and go out there for 20 minutes or something. Let's see how this goes. Gassing. I'm so cooked.
That's fun. Love to do it again tomorrow.
Obviously, we'd like to win nothing less than the gold medal. You know, at some point in time, I'm going to be retiring, and Bill's going to continue playing.
And it's wide! Stein Metzger and Mike Lambert. How about that? One of the best finals we've seen all year long.
I'd love to be to the point where that I can kind of help him find a partner, too. I'd like to leave him with that ability to take someone and do what I've done for him.
Coming up, Priscilla Lima's video diary in Seaside Heights, New Jersey. Plus, a little later in the show, Hans Stolfus and Ty Loomis' trip to Serbia. Priscilla Lima and Angela Lewis are in the midst of their best season on tour. And as one of our more colorful teams on tour, we thought it appropriate to give them a camera and let them document their trip to Seaside Heights, New Jersey. Here's a little something I like to call Lima time.
So we had to have a little stop so we can have breakfast at Perkins, 1 o'clock in the afternoon. And the day's beautiful outside, so we're trying to find a Walmart so we can get sweatshirts.
Because AVP's in town and it's raining. Good times.
We are at the local Kmart buying warm clothes.
Yes, and I want you guys to check it out, the things we've found so far.
Here's Angela styling the latest Valentino jacket. The latest fashion, carpet.
New matching uniforms to wear
the beach. Oh, big boobs.
Huh? Something in the water over here.
I'm warm.
We have the Holiday Inn and we're gonna see our new roommate.
What? Hello! Say hi. Hello.
It's Thursday night. We just got back at the hotel and we're trying to figure it out what we're gonna wear tomorrow. And it's always like this.
Go Pri, which one do you wanna wear?
You wanna wear the polka dots? We haven't worn them yet.
This is our sponsor, Bikini.
How cute they are.
We have to eat breakfast in the bathroom so we don't wake up Logan. And this is our breakfast of champions.
Oatmeal to go.
Oatmeal.
My fellow Brazilian friend, Paula Roca.
We find it on the beach.
Hey, Adam Jewell.
What's happening, baby?
We got April Ross over here. You getting ready to play? Who?
Put that card
up. No, it's AVP.com. Like it. We are running a little competition. You have to say Logan's full name three times fast. And it's Logan Miley Lay Tom.
What is it?
Because I'm like, okay. Logan Miley Lay Tom. Logan Miley Lay Tom. Logan Miley Lay Tom.
Logan Miley Tom. Logan Logan Bacon Logan.
All right, Logan.
Logan Mike Layton. Logan Mike Layton. Longer Tom. Can't do it. Oh, it's Logan.
Logan Miley
Logan Malele Tom.
Oh, forget it.
What's her name again?
Whatever.
It sounds like Logan might get laid Tom.
That's as fast as I could talk.
No. I'm hurting right now. My brain won't even think that fast.
Is that what I said?
All right, you guys, it's Saturday night. I had such a great time, and I hope you guys had fun too. I hope I could, you know, show you guys a little bit of our silly side, because nobody gets to see that, only the... Bye-bye.
After this, Hans Stolfus and Ty Loomis get silly in Serbia. Kosovo, to be exact. AVP stars Ty Loomis and Hans Stolfus took a trip all the way back to Kosovo to entertain the troops and teach them a little bit about pro beach volleyball. Dig got an inside look through the lens and pen of Hans Stolfus.
It took Kurt Vonnegut over 23 years to finally write about what he had experienced in Dresden. War and death aren't exactly easy subjects to discuss. I will now refocus my attention to the lives of soldiers that Ty Loomis, Angie Akers, Jenn Snyder, and myself were fortunate enough to interact with this past weekend in Kosovo. Quite simply, it's crazy. The country, the region, the trip, the travel we endured, all of it. But oh, so worth it. It was important for us to document the trip on film because I wanted, and Ty wanted, and Jen and Angie, we wanted everyone to see what we were able and to accomplish and be able to do as volleyball players.
I'm Ty Loomis, we're checking in. About to go to Pristina, Serbia. We've been privileged enough to go hang out with some troops, do a camp, an exhibition. So here we are, LAX, about to take off, about 6:10 a.m. Angie calling her boy, checking in. Jen calling her boy, checking in.
What was different about Kosovo is the region itself. I mean, they were communist until 99 in the war that all started with Milosevic between Serbia and Albania. And now they're capitalist. 70% of the population is unemployed. They have running water for 5 hours a day.
Absolutely incredible. As you can see, most of the buildings don't have windows. It's crazy.
Now, why were we there? And what could we possibly have to offer anyone protecting this countryside on a day-to-day basis? I'll tell you why. To provide our soldiers with a little R&R, and to let them see and hang out with a couple of good-looking women in bikinis.
Come on, where's the chatter?
It was really hot. It was probably 95 on average.
You know, I don't know how these guys do it. It's amazing. It's so hot out here.
Jenn Snyder getting an IV.
Sure,
making
sure she's hydrated.
Properly hydrated.
Did you just say, uh-oh?
She's in high spirits. It's all good. They were really, really cool. And everybody was really, really respectful. And I think they were just stoked to kind of just hang out and talk with us.
Ty, did you expect to have such lovely ladies in Kosovo when you showed up?
It's the only thing I've seen in Kosovo.
Thanks.
A really, really cool thing that happened during the exhibition in the clinic was the fact that the soldiers were able to take their shoes off. It's a huge deal. And we didn't know that at the time. Until a soldier informed us later that the officers that were watching were just cringing on the side of the court because everyone was out of uniform. We went to the Church of the Black Madonna, which is where Mother Teresa was meant to have spoken to God and where God gave her purpose in life. And it was amazing because the church was beautiful and it was pretty cool. So we climbed into a cockpit of a Black Hawk helicopter, visited multiple temporary military installations in the region, and spent time hanging out with groups of soldiers that our country should be more than proud of.
It was an amazing trip, and couldn't be happier and more proud of our situation as far as our military situation there. A lot of people aren't aware of it, and it was pretty sweet. And I'm just happy to have the opportunity to do it.
I talk about stress on the AVP all the time, battling it out every weekend against our country's best for top 10 finishes. Let's just say this. This trip put that stress into perspective. May every soldier return home safe.
In just a few, an interview with living legend Eric Fanoia Mawana.
It's good to be back. I was at home. I was enjoying my time with Tucker and my wife, and my blood started to boil.
And a recap from the world's largest annual sporting event, the Volleyball Festival in Reno, where over 700 girls club volleyball teams competed for the prestigious title. Seaside Heights, New Jersey, the Jersey Shore, Atlantic Ocean behind us. Geeter, Eric Fanoia Mawana, the gold medalist from 2000. You've had some time off. Talk about the injuries, what you had to overcome, and how happy you are to be back here.
I had the surgery on my left knee. I had a little meniscus that frayed. I couldn't jump, and I'm a power guy, so I took my time, and now I'm back.
And how do you feel? Good to be back, like competing?
It's good to be back. I was at home. I was enjoying my...